Good morning students, how are you all? Today we are going to start lesson number 5 of class 9th, cell, basic unit of life. Students, you know very well, you must have read in class 8th also regarding cell. It is the structural, basic, fundamental and basic unit of life, means the life cannot be imagined without cell. The cell are very most important part of our life. But when many cells combine together, they form tissues, and when many tissues combine together, they form organ. When many organs combine together, they form organ system. And when many organ systems are combined together, they give rise to an organism. So the smallest unit for making an organism, for making a life, is cell. As you know that whenever we start making home, then which one will be the smallest unit to start making any house? That is brick. When many brick combine together, they form a wall. And when some walls come together, they form a room. And when many rooms combine together, they form house. Isn't it? Same way, cell is also the smallest unit of our life, which combines together to achieve further stages. Okay. Now in this chapter we are going to read prokaryotic cells, eukaryotic cells. Pro, as the name suggests, pro means the early primitive cells, which need not have all the cell organelles, which is not having the nucleus separated from the boundaries of cell wall. Okay, and eukaryotic cell means the cells which are matured, having large size, have all cell organelles defined and nucleus separated from the walls, which we are going to read next in our chapter also. Here I am giving you just introduction. Then multicellular organism, the organisms which are made up of many cells. When many cells combine together, as in human beings, many cells combine together, we consider to be multicellular. Then we will study cell membrane, cell wall, and different type of cell organelles, means cell parts, chloroplast, mitochondria, vacuoles, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus and nucleus. In nucleus we will read chromosomes, their basic structures and numbers. Now let us see regarding discovery of cell. Students, in 1665 Mr. Robert Hooke, an English scientist, he saw the cell, and how he observed, he take a very thin slice of cork. Cork, you understand what is cork? The upper layer of the stem occurs on trees. If we take them, that is cork, and he has taken a very thin slice of it and find and see under the self-made microscope. He invented himself a microscope. Microscope is a device which is used, or instrument which is used, to see the smaller organisms wider. Okay, we can say see them on a larger scale, on a bigger, say, shape. Now what he observed? He observed the structures like honeycomb. You must have seen honeycomb, madhumakhi ka chatta. In that you have seen small compartments made up where the honey collected all the honey bees collected all honey, isn't it? So he named that small compartment as cell. Okay, and first time the living organisms, he discovered that they are made up of small unit. You can see in this slide that microscope was very older one. He himself invented. And what was the first observation regarding cell? You can see that small compartments were there, isn't it? And which he named as cell. In Latin language, we pronounce cell as small rooms. Okay. Now, to know the cell theory, cell history, many scientists given their views, and it was given in your NCERT book also on page number 58, more to know or more to learn. You can see from there also, and here also I am explaining. In 1665, I have told Robert Hooke discovered cell. Then in 1674, Leon Hawke studied a living form the first time, that life is originated, and he discovered it first. And how he see? He take free living cells from the pond water first time and observe under microscope. Then after that 1831, Mr. Robert Brown, he discovered nucleus in the cell. Okay, then in 1838 to 1839, Sclavin and Scammon, they give cell theory. Okay, they told that all the plants and animals are composed of cell, and cell is the basic unit of life. Okay, this was the theory given by Sclandon and Scammon. Okay, in 1839. Then after that, there was one more conclusion given regarding cell. In 1855, Rudolf Virchow, he gave the name again cellula, as cellulo. Okay, and he told that all cells arise from pre-existing cell, means the cells which we have, they are here or arise from the pre-existing cell. After that, many microscopes were discovered, and the source of looking the things much more wider increases. As you know that if you take the example of phone, earlier we have landline phones, isn't it? After that we have Nokia phone. Then the time crosses and the more discoveries will be there. Now we have smartphones. So as the time goes and goes, then the technology increases, and this technology give more foundations, more instruments to our science also. Okay, now see, what are living organism made up of? Living organisms are made up of, as I have told, they are made up of, as building is made up of bricks, living organisms are made up of cell. He has given some examples of unicellular also in this slide. Unicellular are also called single celled. Okay, and example amoeba, paramecium, chlamydomonas are also given to you. Then organisms which are made up of more than one cells, they are called multicellular. As we are there, plants, animals, they are considered to be multicellular. And cells perform different work done given to them. Okay. Now, there are some gadgets as we have discussed that Robert Hooke first saw the things by self-made microscope, and after that many inventions were there. The design of microscope increased more efficiently. Then we have high resolution instruments also to see the smaller objects in a very good manner. Here we have two type of microscope, that is light microscope, which have magnification power range from 100 to 1500. Then electron microscope, that is mostly used to observe many microscopic organisms. Magnification is